island-forming volcanic eruptions seem to be beloved by everyone ranging from geologists to common folk alike. The most notable recent example occurred in December of 2014 when a submarine eruption connected the Hunga Tonga and Hunga Haapai Islands, forming the joint Hunga Tonga-Hunga Haapai Island, which had an approximate area of 3.1 square kilometers. While this island was almost completely destroyed by a climactic eruption during January of 2022, a very different fate occurred at the newest volcanic island on a different continent, specifically Europe. There, the island of Surtsey, which first rose above the ocean's surface on November 14, 1963, not only still remains today, but is teeming with life as different species of seabirds, including puffins, and plant life such as lichens, mosses, and grasses, which have colonized the island in the years since. Although what is now a 1.51 square kilometer or 373.1 acre island has shrunk in the years since its formation, it is still standing strong. But there is another reason Surtsey is so famous. It represented the first time during modern volcanology that scientists were able to observe an explosive shallow submarine eruption, with this eruption type now being called a Surtseyan eruption. But first, you might be wondering why Surtsey remains while its companion in Tonga was largely obliterated. This can be owed to several factors, including Surtsey's less viscous lavas, the fact that the volcanic system it is a part of never produced a caldera, indicating a lack of highly voluminous past explosive eruptions, but most importantly, Surtsey as an event is likely to never erupt again. While Hunga Tonga represented a central stratovolcano which has erupted many hundreds of times, Surtsey encompasses a small part of a broad 775 square kilometer volcanic field known as Vestman Gyre, where it is merely a monogenetic vent. As part of the eastern volcanic zone rifted during early November of 1963, this process caused magma to intrude into the crust. Sometime around November 6, this breached the bottom of the ocean floor, causing the seawater to explosively react with very hot magma, generating a series of explosions. Beginning at a depth of around 130 meters or 427 feet below sea level, the high volume it erupted at caused it to climb more than 120 meters in height within the next week. The fact that an eruption was now ongoing 22 kilometers southwest of the closest major populated city known as Vestman Gyre became known only on November 14, 1963, when explosive activity caused the new island, named Surtur, to climb above sea level. For the next 6 weeks, the eruption continued at a high rate, creating plumes of ash that rose as high as 10 kilometers into the atmosphere, while also creating an ash plateau at Surtur. Then, beginning on December 28th of 1963 and ending on January 6th of 1964, a small mass of lava totaling 10 million cubic meters erupted onto the ocean floor at a new vent known as Surtla. This subsequently ceased, but then in mid-February, a new vent explosively erupted to the west of Surtur. Known as Surtunger, it explosively erupted to form a tough cone during the first 2 months, with the next 12 months defined by gentle lava effusion which formed the island of Surtsey. Then, between May and September of 1965, a new vent rose from the ocean floor to the east of Surtur, climbing to a maximum height of 70 meters above sea level. Yet, largely composed of ash, it was swept away by wave action around a month after it ceased erupting. Between November and December of 1965, eruptive activity occurred at a new vent known as Jolnir, which also climbed to a height of 70 meters above sea level via Surtseyan explosive activity that continued until August of 1966. Eruptive activity then shifted back to Surtur, but this time it erupted effusively. Over the next 9 months, basaltic lava flows expanded the island until the eruption ended. In total, 1.2 cubic kilometers of volcanic rock was erupted across 3.5 years, including about 0.4 cubic kilometers of lava. This lava was fairly resistant to erosion, unlike the primarily ash islands, allowing Surtsey Island to remain standing more than a half century later. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's patrons on Patreon and channel members on YouTube.